Hello, this is Robert, and in this video I would like to discuss working with text files in Visual Studio. So I've set up this little program that loads three libraries, the String Library, IOStream, and FStream. And the FStream library allows me to have IFStream objects and OFStream objects. And so these are my variable names, in file and out file. And so those are the variables that will be associated with the file on the hard drive that I want to open. So then I prompt the user for the file that they would like to open. And then I use CN extraction to get the file name. I'm opening the file using file name. And then I'm going to get the first line from the file using get line. So instead of CN here, I have infile as the input stream. So anything I can do with CN, I can also do with input files. If I had wanted to, I could use extraction and read the first word from the file by saying infile and then extraction and then storing that first word into the variable line or whatever. So the idea is that anything that I can do with CN, I can also do with input files because they are both input stream objects. Okay, then I prompt, or then I say what the line is, the first line from the input file, and then I prompt for the output file name, open the output file name, and then I write line to out file using insertion. Okay, so that does it for this program. It's pretty simple. So let's go ahead and see how we can open text files. So I'm going to go ahead and run this program. Notice over here that I have greeting.txt, and that's the file that I'm going to be opening. So I'm just going to click the green triangle right there to run my program. And it's going to prompt me for the file name. And if I want to, I can type in the file name right there. But Windows makes it a lot easier to open up a text file. All I have to do is grab the text file that I'm interested in opening and drag and dropping it onto the console window right there. This works as long as there are no spaces in the directory path information. Okay, so I just dragged and dropped it onto the command line window, and it copied the file location there for me. Okay, so then it says the first line from the file is hello, how are you? And then it's asking me what I would like to name the output file. So I'll just say output.txt. So then the program is done. Okay, so that's how you can easily open files that aren't in the working directory. Let's go ahead and take a look at placing files in the right location. So the working directory in Visual Studio is the directory that contains the source code file, and I can easily go there by right-clicking on source.cpp and selecting or left-clicking on Open Containing Folder. So if I drag greeting.txt into this working directory, now I don't have to give any of the file path information. I can just use the name by itself. So now that it's in the right location, I'll go ahead and run this program again and then just type the file name right on the command line right there. So greeting.txt, and now it opened up the file without needing to know any of the file path information because greeting.txt was in the working directory. So output.txt. Well, that .txt file is just a standard text file. And so my default program is now Notepad++, so I'll right-click on it And I'll open it with Notepad, and we can see that it's just a regular text file. Okay, so hello, how are you? And the other thing that we should notice here is that we have output.txt. I'm going to go ahead and delete that file. And then I'm going to run my program again to see that the program is going to be creating the output file for us. Remember that we ask for the file name, then we open the file using this statement right here, then we write that line to the file, and then we close our files right there. Okay, so let's run this one more time and we'll see that we're actually going to be creating the output file. So it's no longer in the working directory anymore. So the next time I run it and I type greeting.txt, and then output.txt, if we go back to the working directory one more time, we can see that output.txt was created. If I double click on it, it opens up in Notepad++, which is a pretty good program for manipulating text files, although Notepad does a good job too. Okay, that about does it for opening files with Xcode. I'm sorry, with Visual Studio.